If you need to read a script on camera, I have a perfect solution for you. It's simple and easy and not too expensive. I'm using it right now. I'll break this into two parts: a new camera that lets you look at your screen and still look like you're looking into the camera lens, and a website where you can scroll your text while reading it. Before we get started, let me tell you that I've used a lot of different solutions to both of these problems. I bought at least a dozen teleprompters, had devices that hold my webcam in front of the screen on a piece of plastic, and even used AI to move my eyeballs to look at the camera. And I've tried all types of software that run on my computer, my iPhone, and on websites. In 2024, I can definitely say that this combination I'm talking about in this video is the best I have found. It's a combination of SpeakFlow and the iContact Pro camera. And of course, I have affiliate links down below if you're ready to purchase. Thank you for supporting my YouTube habit. Let's get started with the software first. SpeakFlow runs in your browser, so it works on Macs, PCs, your smartphone, whatever has a browser like Chrome. With SpeakFlow, you can add your scripts, make some adjustments, and start the scrolling. Let's dig in. So here's my SpeakFlow account. You can see I've got a number of scripts here. This is the one I'm working on right now, so I'm going to open that one. And you can see first, it will give you an idea of how long it's going to last. And we can go through here and change the script if you want to do that. It may be, you know, it's easy and simple. And you can even do things like bold certain things if you want to highlight it when you're speaking. You use different colors, things like that. It's a great, great tool. Also, you can do things like import files. What I like to do is just cut and paste from a document right in here. Now, let's start the presentation. And you can see here I've already got it set up to be good for the iContact Pro. And what you're seeing is it's a certain distance down from the top of the screen, which is right where the camera is. This red line is about where the camera is. And so when I click on something, that is going to be the first word that I am starting on. Now, a couple things. Let me work my way around the screen here. So I'm going to scroll up a bit first and show you that you can drag these sliders to adjust the script size. But if it is this wide, everybody's going to see your eyes moving back and forth because that's a long distance across the screen. So what I like to do is make it pretty close to the center here. You can also change the size of the text to whatever size is appropriate for you. What I suggest is using the smallest size that you can read on screen without squinting. So we've got that. Let's go down. You can, of course, go back to edit the script if you need to change something. You can't change it on this screen. You have to go back to the edit. Down in the left, you have the start button. When you're ready to start, have the process of scrolling. There's a couple different ways to scroll. So when you push that start button, it's going to depend on what you have here, what happens. So you can set it to auto. So at a certain speed, when I press start, you'll see the script start moving. And then you can change the speed to be whatever is appropriate for how you read. You can also manually scroll it. So once you press start, if you scroll with your mouse, you can move the screen around as you read. Sometimes this is nice. You can actually set up someone doing this remotely too. But what I like best and I use all the time is this called Flow. So what this does is when you press start, you can see down here these little buttons say, and it says it's listening down here. It's listening to me and trying to find that spot in the script. So, but as I read, if you need to read a script on camera, I have a perfect solution for you. It's easy and simple and not too expensive. I'm using it right now. So you can see it's listening to what I'm saying and it's scrolling the script accordingly. You can also do things in terms of how much space you want between the lines, whether you want it aligned left or centered. I mentioned already the size. For video, you can do your video recording inside SpeakFlow. I use actually something called ScreenFlow to do my recordings because I can do a lot of selections and edit right inside ScreenFlow. Of course, I'll put an affiliate link to that one down too. Flip, this is if you are using an actual physical teleprompter and you need the screen to be mirrored because you're reading from a mirror. full screen remote. So like I said, if you're using another device to control this one is really cool. And this allows you to put something in the background while you're reading this. So say you're actually reading a script on a Zoom meeting or something like that, you can choose overlay and put something in the background. So let me just put Google Translate here. So this is what Google Translate. And so then I can say, I can click here to view tab, SpeakFlow, and you can see that my script is now in front of that window. So if you need to see something while you're reading a script, this is a great option. I haven't seen this with anyone else. So overlay is a really wonderful feature. Let's go down to the last one here is settings. This is where you can tell it what microphone to be listening to. And if you're recording video, that you can tell it which camera to use. Read line, what this does, and this is important for using the iContact camera, by default, it's going to read at the top of the page. So you have to move it down. And let's see here if you'll be able to see this in the background. You kind of see it. Actually, let me turn off that overlay just to make things easier to see right now. There we go. And back to settings. And you can see how that read line and the entire script is moving up and down in the background. So as I mentioned with the iContact camera, because it is going down in the middle of your screen, you want the script to be down in that read line about, you know, 3 or 4 inches down from the top of your screen. You don't have to have the read line. If you just want to have it, it will highlight the words as you speak them and they will turn gray. So that's it. When you're ready, just push start. And also, as you go along, you can always use your mouse, even with flow turned on, you can use it to scroll back and say, oh, I want to start that paragraph over, and just click the spot that you want to start. And it will start on that line. So it makes it really super easy to be able to record a script without it looking like you're reading a script because you're looking very close to the camera and your eyes aren't moving back and forth. SpeakFlow has 3 tiers of pricing plus a free plan. I think the free plan is limited by how long your script can be, like a couple of minutes. You can see the items that are included in the different plans here. I'm on the $15 a month plan, and the reason I bumped up from the basic plan is to get the overlay feature. So now you have a software for scrolling your text as you speak. You need to get your camera close to the point on the screen where you are reading. And to do that, the best option I've found is the iContact Pro. As I mentioned earlier, I've tried a lot of devices like this, and this is the first time I really like one. It just folds down when you need to use it. And you can adjust the SpeakFlow window on your screen to put the script right below the camera and make sure the script isn't too wide or the audience will see your eyes moving back and forth. I have another video with tips to look great when reading the script like this. It takes some practice to make it look natural, but you'll find that video up here. Thanks for watching.